Sup, all JC3 here, the baller of YouTube, the general. Welcome to Toppy Tackle. My take for today is on the biggest winners and losers of the 2019 NBA Draft Lottery. We saw some unexpected outcomes go down, and I'll get into detail on those in this video. Before I get into this, keep in mind for the end of the video to check out my past couple of videos, and shout out to y'all for the support that you've shown on the last one, Kobe's prediction on James Harden. I've really enjoyed reading all your feedback, and let's get started. First, the biggest losers. And no, I'm not talking about the reality TV show. Get off my screen, Bob Harper. Of course, I gotta mention the Knicks.
Typical Knicks, man. I knew it. They'd get close, they'd tease us, then they wouldn't get it done.
And sorry, Knicks fans, but y'all already know, this was your chance to secure Zion Williamson. Not in the Tims, though. I mean, what are we doing, Bleacher Report? You'll have to settle with the third pick, which is gonna be good, but Zion truly is a generational talent in terms of athleticism and efficiency. Coupled in with the Knicks as a big loser in this whole thing is Zion Williamson, because as we know, he had hopes of playing for the Knicks.
If they draft me, I would love to play for the Knicks. Like, I'm not really, like, I don't really care where I go. Like, just the experience of being in the NBA, whoever wants me, and whoever sees the most of me, that's where I want to be.
So for that reason, he's a loser in this lottery for now. But it's always difficult to do one of these prediction videos because the hindsight is 2020, and it may turn out better for Zion's career that he never was drafted by the Knicks. Other big losers are the Cavs, Suns, and Bulls. It's especially unfortunate for the Cavs and Suns, who finished tied for the second worst record in the NBA and didn't even crack the top four. They both had a 14% chance at the number one pick, and teams with a 2% chance, the Lakers, and 6% chance, the Grizzlies and Pelicans, cracked the top four. The number two pick went to the Grizzlies, and this is the likely destination for sophomore stand-up point guard Ja Morant from Murray State. While I'm happy for him that he's going to be drafted so high, Morant received little attention from the national audience while at Murray State, and this isn't likely to change on the Memphis Grizzlies either. Gonna have to get league pass on this one. All right, now to the winners, and of course, the New Orleans Pelicans are the biggest winner in this draft lottery. Only a 6% chance, but it was enough on this night to secure the top spot and almost certainly draft Zion. That's going to help their franchise going forward from a ratings and ticket perspective, regardless of what happens with Anthony Davis, who, by the way, is another big winner on this night. Reports are that he still wants a trade, but now New Orleans may be more inclined to deal him for pieces to build around Zion. Now, my wild take is this. Why don't the Pelicans trade the number one pick, which is probably going to be Zion, to the Lakers, straight up for LeBron James, and he'll finally have his wish come true to play with Anthony Davis? Well, I don't know if that's even a possibility, but hey, I'm throwing it out there. Now, the team who didn't get the number one pick has already been mentioned as the biggest loser. But RJ Barrett, the projected number three pick, is a winner in this case. He will most likely get to play on one of the biggest stages in basketball and prove to everyone that he's the self-proclaimed best player in the draft. The Grizzlies and Lakers round out our winners as Memphis secured the number two spot and the Lakers jumped into the top four after the 11th pick went to Minnesota. All right, to conclude, I believe the NBA is a big winner in this draft lottery. They won on the front of exposing tanking with the implementation of their new percentage odds. In the past, the worst team by record would receive a 25% chance to secure the top pick, and this year it was changed to the top three worst teams by record, each receiving a 14% chance to secure that top pick. This strongly discourages tanking, and it worked tonight, as only one of those three worst teams received a top three pick. I also believe that besides the Lakers anomaly, this draft lottery was the furthest thing from rigged that we've seen in a while. Neither of the association's two most valuable franchises financially received the top pick, and as I posted, we can't complain that the Pelicans got the number one pick when we all would have called it rigged if the Lakers or Knicks got it. Now, you could view this as a negative, but all the talk was about building up small market teams after LeBron left Cleveland for Miami and KD left OKC for Golden State. So, y'all are getting what you asked for. So, let me know what you think in the comments down below. Who are your biggest winners and losers of the 2019 NBA Draft Lottery? Remember to subscribe, like, and leave your feedback in the comments down below, and we'll be back with more Toppy Tackle coming soon. JC3, out.